Welcome back to the Junk Room, everybody. It's me, the Junk Man, coming back at you with another video. Coming back at you. I don't know what that meant. Sorry, just off the top of my head. Before we get started, as always, if you want to support this channel, head over to Patreon.com. We got new tiers coming out the first of the year and some great stuff coming, including a junk box can be sent right to your house. Anyway, let's get on with the video about how one time Kenner upset goat farmers.
Well, Betsy, it looks like old Kenner did it again.
Oh no, don't tell me they done killed another kid.
It was way back in 1979, and Kenner would upset the farming community with the release of an all-new toy. What could have been so bad? Was it the back-talking hoe? Or the clean-yourself dirty little pig? Nope, because I made those two up. So what could it be that upset the farmers? It was Gobblers, the crazy-eating goat. Gobblers was, as Kenner called it, a realistic-looking goat that ate garbage. All you had to do was pump the goat's tail, and he swallowed all of that garbage. I'm only happy when it rains. No, not that garbage. Plastic toy garbage and plastic cans. Inside his mouth was a conveyor belt that pulled the trash into his stomach. To remove the trash, all you had to do is open the basket on the goat's side. Gobbler even made a chewing sound as he ate the plastic garbage and let out that famous goat sound. That sound was activated by pushing the basket on his side. The toy goat came with 7 pieces of plastic garbage, and it was recommended for kids 3 to 8 years old. Although, if you ask me, it sounds like it's fun for all ages. So how could farmers be upset about such a fun toy? As you know, no matter what you do, someone will be upset about it. Fuck out of here. And those someone upset this time were farmers, mostly goat farmers.
You dang varmint, you.
One of those upset goat farmers was Marty Kane of Kenesha's Kid Goat Farm, who said,
"It's degrading to the goat. They don't eat garbage. They're frisky eaters. They're browsers. They eat leaves and grains."
Marty didn't seem to be the only goat lover upset. Goat lover Gene Williams of Corain Township, near Kenner's hometown of Cincinnati, was also upset. As he told his local newspaper,
"Kenner knew that was a bad toy. That's why they took it off the market."
So was everyone so upset at the toy-eating goat that Kenner pulled it from shelves? Or were just a few goat farmers raising a stink? Kenner spokesman John Middleton III said this about the goat.
"Gobbler was dropped from toy shelves, but it's still available at your local Sears."
Put on your Sunday best, kids. We're going to Sears.
Kenner would never admit that the toy goat was a bad idea, even if the goat farmers said it was. And they also would never admit that it was degrading to goats. Middleton did admit that before the release of the eating goat, Kenner met with the Goat Association. Yes. Apparently, there's a goat association. Do you like goats? Or do you love goats? I mean, do you really love goats? If so, join your local goat association today. Help spread the word. Goats are sweet, loving animals who should not be the butt end of uneducated joke makers and a seasonal merchandise for a toy company trying to make a few extra bucks. If you love goats, be it billy goats, mountain goats, milking goats, Spanish goats, or any other type of goats at all, join today the Goat Association. Call now 1-800-LOVE-A-GOAT. Middleton said this about the meeting.
"They thought it made fun of goats, so we promised to include a flyer with a toy explaining the real facts about goats."
When asked why the toy goat was taken off the shelf, Middleton said this.
"It wasn't very successful. Most toys aren't."
Did it not sell because kids didn't want to feed a plastic goat plastic trash? Or did the Goat Association have a lot more power with toy stores than Kenner thought? We may never know the real reason why the toy didn't sell. And honestly, that's all right with me. Oh yeah. I might add that Kenner did also release Alvin, the anteater aardvark. As far as I can find out, the Anteater Aardvark Association had no issue with the selling of Alvin. As for Milky the Milk Cow, well, that's a whole different story.
Thank you, sir, for that unsolicited testimony.